is the World According to Zig podcast for September 29, 2019. My name is John Ziegler. I'm the host of the show where you can still get the truth about the news of the day from a conservative perspective in this world turned upside down. As is always the case, please check out my other podcast, the Individual One podcast, about news related to President Donald Trump. You can find that at our website, www.freespeechbroadcasting.com. As has been the case for much of 2019, although this was never anticipated, this episode is going to be devoted to the never-ending saga of the Leaving Neverland controversy, the so-called HBO documentary, actually a fantasy film about accusations involving Michael Jackson and sexual abuse. And yesterday, I spent most of the day in Hollywood at the premiere of a brand new documentary which intends to combat at least some of those allegations, as well as the original allegations against Michael Jackson. It's a movie called Square One by a filmmaker by the name of Danny Wu. It was very, very good. I'm going to talk about that with Taj Jackson and Charles Thomson, as well as many other things related to the allegations against Michael Jackson. But first, I want to play an interview that I did with Michael Jackson's criminal defense attorney, Tom Mesereau, the great Tom Mesereau, who was his attorney in the 2005 criminal trial where Michael Jackson was acquitted of all charges. This was an interview done with Tom Mesereau immediately after the film Square One ended. This was a tough interview for me to get because I was sitting right next to Tom during the film. So as soon as the film ended, I said, "Hey, Tom, what are your thoughts?" And here was his reaction. Tom, we just got through watching the premiere of Square One, and I'm curious what your reaction to it was.
It's a fabulous film. It is high quality. It was carefully investigated. The evidence was carefully looked through. It was condensed in a very professional attempt to find the truth. And it tells the truth. Michael Jackson was not a pedophile. He never should have been put through what he was put through, starting with the case in 92, 93. And I commend Danny Wu and all of his people for the fabulous job they did. And I can't wait to hear this circulating through society because we live in very, very biased, troubled times. Michael Jackson was never a pedophile, never should have been accused as such. And his life was destroyed by greed, by people without integrity, by people without a conscience. And this film starts the road back from some of the recent developments which have been very troubling.
Wow, that's a powerful statement coming from you, his criminal defense attorney, obviously in the 2005 acquittal. Was there one portion of the film that you thought was most powerful?
Well, I think all parts were powerful because they tied together very well. And the producer, Mr. Wu, obviously wanted to present things in a logical, careful, coherent way. He did a tremendous job in showing the truth. It's not a scattered film. It's not a film that revolves around passion. It's a film that revolves around the facts and the truth and logic. It is a fantastic film.
The part that I found most powerful, because it's always been a point of confusion for me, was the settlement with Jordy Chandler. And what I found interesting is that when you see the timeline and you see even just the family tree and everything placed in its proper order, it's actually quite understandable how that all happened.
Well, when I appeared first, the first time I appeared in the criminal case in Santa Maria, California, I gave a statement that addressed that issue. And I made a statement because it was clear that many members of the public were troubled by that amount of money. The feeling was nobody would pay that amount of money if they were innocent. And the fact is, Michael Jackson was the most famous gifted entertainer, perhaps in world history. Michael Jackson could walk anywhere around the world and make a fortune at that point in time. His advisors and lawyers told him this is a drop in the bucket and the bad publicity. It's a sound investment, and he listened to them. They didn't write the check, he did, and he later regretted it. He told me, "It's the biggest mistake I ever made. I should have fought that case like I'm fighting the one with you, Tom." And I wanted to make clear that this was not something that he did willingly. He did it for many reasons. One, business-wise, and two, if you look at the Bashir documentary, he makes a statement. He says, "I didn't want to put my family through an OJ-type case." So there were many compelling reasons why Michael Jackson did this. He was advised to do it. He wrote the check. The advisors didn't. And unfortunately, it was a big mistake.
Tom, as always, well said, and always good to see you.
Thank you. Same. Good to see you. We'll see you soon.
Thanks, Tom.